Good morning, students. In last class, we discussed the mailings tab. It is nothing but the one more name for this tab is that mail merge. So mail merge is an option where one has to send letter with identical information to a group of people who resides at different locations. Means if I want to send the same information to number of people on the time, so we can use the mail merge option. Mail merge is completely different from email. So mail merge is one of the option or one of the feature from MS Word, and for this one we don't want internet facility. And to email means if I want to send any message, electronic mail on that time, so we want the internet connection. Mail merge consisting of five basic steps. First one is that we have to set up a main document. So main document may be letter, email message, envelope, labels or directory. Second option is that we have to create a data source. It is nothing but the recipient or sender's address. Third one is that refine or edit list of recipients. Once we have created the data source of recipients, if I want to do any changes on the time, we can do the changes at there. And fourth one is that add a placeholder called mail merge fields to the main document. And final step is that we have to preview and complete the merge. So step one is very easy. So first click on mailings tab, then start mail merge mailings, start mail merge group is there. In that click on start mail merge drop down button. So it displays a step by step mail merge wizard command. So on the right side, so it will display a 6 diagrams. Out of that, we have to select the only one option from each diagram. So wizards are nothing but set of boxes, and we have to select a only one option from there. This mail merge is important for the exam, and it's a case study question. For that one, you have to write a letter, then totally 12 steps are there. Along with that, you have to draw the 6 diagrams. So for diagrams, 7 marks, and for 12 steps, 8 marks. So totally 15 marks. It's a case study question. Now we will move to the next tab, that is review tab. So review tab consists of 6 groups: proofing, comments, tracking, changes, compare and protect. Proofing group consisting of number of commands. First one is that spelling and grammar. Second one is that research. So research includes thesaurus, translate, translation screen tip. Next one is set language and word count. So totally we can say spelling and grammar one option, research one option, set language one option, and word count one option. So what is the use of spelling and grammar? So it is a powerful tool which automatically checks spellings in a paragraph on an entire document. It put red wavy underline for mistake words and green wavy underline for grammatical mistake, so that you can easily spot them on the screen. So I will show so how we can do the spelling and grammar checkings. So I have inserted here 3 paragraphs. Now I will make one small mistake. Instead of G-A-L-L-E-R-I-E-S, I will make it as G-A-L-L-E-R-E-S. And for formatting, instead of A, I will delete this A. So you can easily recognize. So it shows a red wavy underline. And if we do any grammatical mistake on that time, it will show a green wavy underline. So how to check this one? So just select this word, then click on review tab, proofing group, and click on spelling and grammar. It opens a spelling and grammar dialog box. Here, two text boxes are available. These are the text boxes because it includes a text here. Galleries, this word is in red color and here it is in a red wavy underline. Here, suggestion box is there. So, what I have to make the changes? So, galleries, then RIAS is there, then RIES, then apostrophe is there, then GOALERS is there. So, which one I want, I have to select that word and I have to click on this change button. If I click on change button, what happens? Automatically, it changes the mistaken word. And second option, next button is that change all. So, it is used to change all mistake words which appears elsewhere in the document. For example, if I do the same mistake, gallery spelling, elsewhere in the same file, and if I want to change all the words at a time, then click on change all button. Next here is ignore once option is there. Means if my this gallery word is correct, on that time you can ignore it. And ignore all, if the same mistake words comes elsewhere in the document and that my word itself is the correct and I want to remove all these red wavy underlines, on that time click on ignore all. Next one is that add to dictionary. If I want to add some of the words to the dictionary, because MS Word creates normally, if I want to search any words meaning or if I want to correct the word, on that time we are using a dictionary. Same way MS Word having its own dictionary, and if I want to add some of the words to this dictionary, and you have to click on add to dictionary. Once you add to this particular words to the dictionary, next time it doesn't show the mistake, means red wavy underline to that particular word. Last one is the autocorrect, which automatically corrects the word. So, I will show it later. So, here I have to click on change button and click on yes, click on close. So, here you can easily identify the galleries, automatically it change. So, one more option is that we have to right click on that mistaken word instead of click on review and spelling grammar button. What you can do is that right click on this mistaken word, it shows a menu here. From here itself you can do the changes. So here change the formatting. So next one is that auto correct word. So I will click on spelling and grammar. It's over now. Make it as change now spelling and grammar. I will click on autocorrect option, which automatically corrects the word. Okay. Next one is that research option. Research includes number of commands. Here, first one is thesaurus. What is thesaurus? Using a research feature, you can look up synonyms, that is different words with same meaning, as well as we can find the antonyms, words with opposite meaning in the thesaurus group. So, for example, if I want to change, if I want to find the similar meaning of insert, what you can do is that select this word, then click on the thesaurus option. Right side, it will open a research feature and here thesaurus options are available. That is, what are the meanings of insert button, insert word? See, a put in, place in, pop in, slot in, interleave, introduce. Then instead of that one, verb options are there. Add, include, make the addition, append, incorporate. Other than that, supplement, pull out, different options are there. Means it finds a similar meaning of this word. And if I want to change that one, instead of insert, if I want to make it as add, just click on this button. So here, search. It finds the meaning of the particular words. So it is not possible to insert that word here. We can only identify the meaning of the particular word. Next one is that translate. I will select this particular paragraph. Translation command. This translate is used where you can translate from one language to another language. MS Word consisting of number of bilingual dictionaries. Here I can convert from one language to another language. So I will select this one. Now I will click on this translate button. On the right side, here translation option is there. Translate a word or sentence from English. This is English. Now I will change it to Persian. So select this one. See here. You can easily identify it. See here, it changes to Persian. Now here is from, this is a English language. Now I will change it to Tamil. See here, it changes to Tamil. So if it is in Kannada, I will check once the Kannada option is there. I don't know. No, Hindi is there. So click on Hindi. So here, so Hindi comes. So translation option, translate command is used to convert from one language to another language. Next one comes translation screen tips. Here you can enable enhanced screen tips that translates words that you pause with your mouse pointer. The language supported by default are English, French and Spanish. So while translating from one language to another language, if I want any one of the translation screen tip, on that time you can add it. So it is available default, it is available in only three languages: English, French and Spanish. Here it shows Arabic also, so I have turned off it because I don't want the translation script. Next one is set language. This option is used to make word detect a text you typing in a different language from the language of the active keyboard. Means in which language I have to type. So if I want to select this one, you go for set language option. Different options are there. African is there, Albania is there, France is there, Ethiopia is there, Algeria is there. So in which language you want to type, you can select that language and click on OK. So normally if I want to type in Kannada, I want one app that is Nudi. Same way, if I want to write these language words in MS Word, on that time we have to first install that particular application. After that we have to activate this set language. And last one is word count. So word count option is used to count the number of words, characters, paragraphs, lines in the document. So word count is not used to count the number of words. So it counts the number of characters, words, paragraph and line. So just click on this word count. Here pages one is there. Words, totally 53 words are there. Then characters, no space, 287. Characters with space, 339. So paragraph 1 is there. Then lines 4. This is only for the first paragraph. So now I will select all three paragraphs. Then I will click on this word count option. See here, total lines are 12. You can easily spot them in first paragraph 4 lines, second paragraph 4 line, third paragraph 4 line. So total 12 lines, 3 paragraphs are there. Characters 898 and characters with no space 898, characters with space 1080, and total number of words are 185, and only one page is there. So this is about the proofing. So in next class we discussed about the comments and tracking. Thank you one and all.